Everyone says I love you, but just what they say it for I never knew. It's just inviting trouble for the poor sucker who says I love you.
I love good music.
So do I. Let's get out of here.
Sit down.
Will you keep quiet? Now, we've got to work fast. Baxter might come back.
Hey, don't be afraid. If any trouble starts, we'll telephone for help.
Telephone? This is 1870. Don Amici hasn't invented the telephone yet.
There she is, gentlemen. Proceed.
Ah, that's a boy. That's a boy.
Come on, Mary Lou. We can relax in here.
Okay.
Those dopes are in there trying to crack open the safe. Send for Baxter and the boys.
Well, where are they?
I don't know. Find them.
How can I find them? I don't know where they are.
Wait a minute. Did you say something?
I don't say nothing.
Well, if it's me, my voice is suddenly changing.
Hello, YouTube and YouTubettes. Welcome to another Marx Brothers movie review. I am Robbo.
And I'm Becco.
And today we're going to review The Marx Brothers Go West.
New Yorkers Rusty Pinello and his brother Joe cheat Quentin Quayle out of some money, enough to buy themselves a train trip out west. All three soon find themselves involved in a feud between the Turner and Wilson clans and two crooked land promoters. In order to help two lovers marry, Quayle and the Pinello brothers pursue the crooks on an eastbound train in a madcap race for justice.
Becco, tell us about the cast.
Groucho Marx plays Quentin Quayle. Diana Lewis plays Eve Wilson. June McCloy plays Lulu Bell. Harpo Marx plays Rusty. Chico Marx plays Joe. Iris Adrian plays Mary Lou. Robert Barat plays Red Baxter. And John Carroll plays Terry Turner.
So, Becco, what did you think of the story of this movie?
The story was pretty good. It was somewhat of, I guess you could say, a stereotypical kind of Western, like Easterners meets Western, where there's a good guy and a bad guy and everything. So I thought the story was pretty good. It was pretty engaging. And overall, the telling of the story was done pretty well.
I agree. I think, the whole plot line of the couple in love, I think it's kind of like Romeo and Juliet because they're from two families that apparently hate each other, but they fall in love. And in order to save, I guess there's the whole thing about the selling that land and getting, to be able to afford a wedding and all that stuff. I think, but it's very interesting. It keeps you into the what's going on. What's your favorite scene in the movie?
My favorite scene was the train scene at the end. I thought it was pretty funny and well done, and it was a lot of action, but it also helped keep the plot going. It was a very long part of the movie. Even though it was just supposed to be kind of that climactic chaos scene, it was actually like half the movie. But that was my favorite.
I agree. I also had that. It was just an exciting kind of scene. And that's what I also put is, there was a lot of little bits and things in there that kept it interesting. So it didn't get ridiculous or boring. And so what's your overall score for the plot?
My score for the storyline is a 7.
And I gave it an 8. Okay, next let's talk about the quality of the movie. What are your thoughts on that?
I thought the quality was pretty good for a movie from its time. The Marx Brothers always have some good gags, and there were plenty of those that were pretty impressive. There was a lot of, I guess, special effects, I guess you could say, for the time, like stuff with the train and things like that, that were pretty well done. It was all fairly realistic in how they did the train. I mean, silly moments, but still, the quality, I think, and just overall, the way that it was filmed and stuff was pretty decent.
Mm-hmm. Some of the stuff in the train, though I acknowledge it is probably a step further, but reminded me of the style of, say, a Buster Keaton or Charlie Chaplin
sure.
movie, like where Harpo, like the house is on the train, and mm-hmm. Harpo steps into the door and out the other door, which is something similar to what they would do in a silent mm-hmm. film. The scene where Harpo gets stretched when uh-huh. he's holding two trains together is kind of cartoonish.
Yeah.
But I agree. I think the quality was pretty solid throughout, and I didn't see any major editing errors or anything. Do you have any thoughts on, like, the set designs or costuming or anything of that nature?
It was all decent. There wasn't a whole lot that just stood out to me. One thing I did notice is that all the Marx Brothers movies up until then have all been filmed in, like, the modern era, the day that it was mm-hmm. filmed, it took place in that day. But yeah. Go West takes place in the 1870s.
Yeah.
So that was kind of different. And they were doing, you know, some different types of costumes and stuff. And then, of course, Groucho's and Chico's and Harpo's costumes are always a little over the top. But they were still of that era, or, you know, trying to be of that era. So the costumes were all pretty solid and consistent. But, yeah, that was just an interesting thing that I thought of, that all of the other ones took place in the modern day when it was filmed. But this one takes place in the old Western times.
So what's your score for quality?
I give the quality a 6.
And I gave it a 7. Okay, now we're going to talk about the music. So what is your thought overall of the music quality in this movie?
The music was pretty good. There were a couple of really good songs in this. But just in general, you know, the sound quality and everything and the songs themselves were all pretty good. There was one song in the woman that works in the saloon sings. And she has kind of not a very good voice. It's like extremely deep, where she sounds like a man. And the song wasn't that great. But there were a lot of other really good songs that almost made it difficult to decide what my favorite song would be.
Yeah, I agree. The music overall was pretty high quality. And even though I would agree that Woman in the Salon was probably the weakest song in the whole movie, I probably liked it a little more. I didn't mind it. I think it's a unique voice, and that's probably mm-hmm. what I liked about it, like this unique alto mm-hmm. singer. But of course, what Groucho was doing really made that scene at that time. But yeah, a lot of good songs. So was there one that you were able to pick as your favorite?
There was. There was actually two that stood out, but there's a song, the Riding the Range song, was just really good. It was just the melody of it was good, in the way that they kind of sing like different parts. Like there's like a descant to it. So Groucho and all the Marx Brothers sing along with the leads. And it's just a nice little catchy song. But there's also a scene where just as in Marx Brothers fashion, where Harpo and Groucho play their instruments.
Chico,
that's right. Mm-hmm. Chico plays the piano and Groucho plays the harp.
Although Groucho does play the guitar in this,
yes,
Riding the Range.
Yeah. But just the instrumental pieces, like when they're with the Indian reservation, or, you know, mm-hmm. he's playing that loom that mm-hmm. he turns into a harp. I mean, it's a little bit silly, but at the same time, it's kind of genius.
Mm-hmm.
But all of the instrumental music was just really, really good. Probably some of the best of all the movies.
I agree. Riding the Range is also a great song. I agree. And I also noted that Chico and Harpo had some of their best. With Chico, the thing he did with the orange, you know, that Harpo was about to eat, and then he did some interesting things with it. And of course, he played something a little different, and you got to see his fingers a little more closely. So it was very good. But I also had Harpo's piece as my favorite. just the style of music I felt like was a little different than he normally does. And although at the end he does his famous tags that he does in most of his stuff, but a lot of it was this jazz kind of thing that was not typical of the kind of music he would play. So that's also my favorite. So what's your score on the music?
I would give the music a 7.
And I gave it a 9. All right, let's talk about performances, the characters and actors.
There were a lot of really good characters in this movie. Even just the secondary characters, there were several that were just really good, good acting, good performing. Just in general, they were they told the story well, and even the secondary actors were pretty hilarious.
Mm-hmm. I felt that, so oftentimes in old black and white movies, sometimes the straight characters can be cheesy and sometimes they can be good. And it's kind of hit and miss for me. And the same thing is true in Marx Brothers movies. And I felt like this was one of the better ones. They weren't cheesy at all. They were very solid. And so I really enjoyed that. So do you have a favorite non-Marx Brother?
Yes, I really liked the saloon girls, and I know that's not one character, but just those three ladies together, mm-hmm. they had a lot of funny bits. But I also really liked Baxter, which I think he was one of the bad guys.
Mm-hmm.
But
younger one?
No, I think he was the older one,
okay.
Red Baxter.
Mm-hmm.
But he was, like, really funny.
Yeah.
Almost a comedian himself, just the way he played his part.
Mm-hmm.
So just those little touches like that, where oftentimes those secondary characters, there's not as much of attention given to them, and they tend to be not that great, but they were all pretty good in this one.
Yeah, and I had the younger bad guy, and I can't remember his name right now, but he was also in A Day at the Races.
Oh, yes.
And I had to give a nod to him. It was another one of those that was hard to pick because everybody played their parts really well.
Mm-hmm.
But I went ahead and picked him. How about of the Marx Brothers? What was your thought of their performances overall?
They were all pretty good. Harpo definitely stood out to me in this one. Yeah, I think that definitely is one of my favorite ones with him.
Mm-hmm. I also had a difficult time picking, but I picked Chico in this one, and I thought he did a very solid job.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember specifically any scenes right off the top of my head, but I just thought he stood out as a very good, sometimes his best performances, he's sort of the tweener guy where he's able to work with the straight characters and with the comedy characters.
Mm-hmm.
In both cases, and sometimes he plays the straight man to Harpo,
yeah,
and things. So in this one, I'll give it to Chico. So what's your overall score for performances?
I give the performances a 7.
And I give it a 9. All right, the humor in the movie. So what are your overall thoughts?
It was a very funny movie, very consistent. And like I said before, even the non-Marx Brother characters were pretty funny. But yeah, this was definitely a good solid one, but that also had good comedy as well. Some of it was silly, and then some of it was just good comedy.
Mm-hmm.
I think my favorite funny scene was the scene where the saloon girls get the guys drunk, when mm-hmm. really they're trying to do the opposite. They're trying to get the girls drunk, or the girls to give them information. And simultaneously, is it Harpo's trying to open the safe? I thought that scene was pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
And not super cliche and like a million other routines that you've seen the Marx Brothers do before. This one was a little bit different. Harpo was on his own. And Chico was kind of with the ladies, flirting mm-hmm. with the ladies, which you normally don't see him do. Sometimes you see Harpo doing that, and you definitely mm-hmm. see Groucho doing that. Mm-hmm. But in this one, you see Chico and Groucho together while mm-hmm. Harpo is on his own. So That was a good scene and funny too.
Yeah, I also think that the comedy was pretty strong in this movie. A few scenes that stick out to me: the beginning where Chico is scamming Groucho, which is very formulaic, but I think it was well done, mm-hmm. and they just did a few things that were unique to past times. But I couldn't pick that one because it is, similar to things they've done in the past. I also noted the in the wagon, where they're in the wagon. Now, some things that I don't, some plot holes, I guess, is how Groucho got ahead of them, like when he was trying to hitch a ride.
Yes.
And how did they get, they were trying to get on.
Similar to Big Circus where you're like, mm-hmm. how did he get there when he was over here?
Uh-huh.
It's probably just one of those things that movie writers don't think of.
And Chico and Harpo were trying to get money to get a ticket for a train, and yet mm-hmm. they were on a wagon. So, but, it's in a comedy. I don't know how important that is. I should have mentioned that in the quality as far as editing.
Yeah.
But my favorite scene was also when Harpo's opening the safe and Chico and Groucho are getting drunk and, mm-hmm. and dealing with the three women, and that was just hilarious. So what's your overall score for comedy?
I gave it a 6.
And I gave it a 9. Your final score for Marx Brothers Go West?
6.5.
And I gave it an 8.5.
Mr. Horace Greeley was no fool. I'm sure that you agree with me that Greeley was no fool.
What he is getting at is that Mr. Greeley was no fool.
The wisdom of a man can be denied by none, for he's the one that said.
Before you go to Buffalo, to Baltimore, or Borneo, to Eastern Pennsylvania, or Japan,
go west. Young man,
if you go to that land, sonny, you will have a lot of money if you bring the money with you when you come
to the long prairie. Yippee-yee,
yippee-yee, yippee-yee-yee-yee,
yippee-yee-yippee-yee-yippee-yee.
Before you read a travel ad and scamper off to Trinidad, to Albany, New York, or Yucatan,
go west, young man.
In the east they live on donuts, in the west the natives grow nuts, and I'll guarantee you'll go nuts if you come
to the long prairie. Yippee-yi, yippee-yi,
yippee-yi, yi, yi,
yippee-yi, yippee-yi, yippee-yi.
A cowboy's gal is a real true pal. She will stick to him right or wrong.
Right or wrong.
She don't say nothing, and she don't do nothing, and she don't know nothing, and she don't want nothing but a horse and a cowboy. Oh, she just keeps a-rolling along.
Go west, young man. Go where the air puts hair in your chest, young man.
You can ride a bucking pronghorn or a pony. You can cut a calf in half and make bologna.
Go west, young man. Go right out there and give them the very best you can.
Don't go east, don't go south, don't go north, have a care. Don't go up, don't go down, don't go here, don't go there. If it's true what they say about Dixie.
Go west, young man.
Go out and till the soil there. Dig for gold and you'll find oil there.
As the crow flies when the snow flies, go west with hope.
If you are fond of hunting, there's no place that can compare. You may not bag a lion or a tiger or a bear, but if you want a jackass, there are plenty of them there.
Go west, young man.
The judges there are very fair, they always are, of course. A cowboy and his missus went to court for a divorce. The cowboy got the children, and the missus got the horse.
Go